Hey everyone, welcome to our 8th episode of Virtuous Eve by Word Ignite Catholic Lay Ministry. As always, I'm your host Calvin D'Souza, and here with us is Sister Jessie. Hello, Sister.
Hey Calvin.
How's it going?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. I hope you had a blessed Divine Mercy week and you're doing well right now. A warm welcome to our patrons and wonderful viewers who join us week after week. Thank you so much. And welcome to our next episode today. Luke 1:37 says, "For nothing will be impossible with God." Scripture tells us numerous times that nothing is impossible with God. The Bible encourages us to believe in God and that all things are possible with him. We're going to reflect on the life of Saint Elizabeth from the Bible, who was the mother of John the Baptist and the wife of Zechariah, according to the Gospel of Luke. A righteous woman from the descendant of the priestly line of Aaron, she was a kinswoman of the Virgin Mary. According to the Gospel, Elizabeth had lived a blameless life with her husband in one of the hill towns of Judea. Having reached an advanced age with her prayers for a son unanswered, she thought that her barrenness was a reproach. She conceived her son miraculously as an old woman after her husband received a revelation while serving at the Temple of Jerusalem. During her pregnancy, she and Zechariah provided hospitality to Mary, the mother of Jesus, who visited the couple immediately after receiving her own revelation that she too would miraculously conceive a son. Elizabeth acted prophetically in greeting Mary by sensing that her young cousin would be the mother of my Lord. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. For behold, the moment the sound of your greeting came to my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy." In this episode, we will learn about Elizabeth's character and the life that she lived, which made her a great saint to be remembered forever. Jessie, could you tell us more about Saint Elizabeth?
Thank you, Calvin, for this wonderful introduction about Saint Elizabeth. Saint Thomas Aquinas beautifully said once, "Obedience unites us so closely to God that in a way transforms us into him, so that we have no other will but his. If obedience is lacking, even prayer cannot be pleasing to God." Now that brings me to the first point about the character of Saint Elizabeth that we learn, as you shared in the introduction, that she was a woman of obedience because she and her husband obeyed everything that the Lord had commanded them. We read in the Bible in John chapter 14, verse 23, Jesus replied, "Those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them. And we will come to them and make our home with them." Where there is obedience, there is always the indwelling of God. And the Holy Trinity comes to make their home with us. It is God's will that we remain in fellowship with him for all eternity. God wants to spend time with you. God does not judge you based on what he sees or hears, but by his love. That is beyond your circumstances, your feelings, or your struggles, or your achievements, or your status in life. His love accompanies you in moments of your distress, in your pain and your disappointment, or maybe poverty, or failures, or brokenness, or sickness, or your worries and anxieties, or in fact, even in your death. But it is we who fail to understand that he not only sustains us, but also journeys with us in our struggles. At this moment, each one of us is as close to God as we choose to be. And that's why Saint Gregory the Great said, "By the other virtues, we offer God what we possess. But by obedience, we offer ourselves to him. They who obey are conquerors. Because of submitting themselves to obedience, they triumph over the angels who fell through disobedience." He continues to say, "When we humbly give way to another's voice, we overcome ourselves in our own hearts." The sacrifice that Jesus offered to the Father is thus so perfect because he who was equal to God humbled himself and became obedient even unto death. We too can do the same if we follow his example and place our trust, our hope, and our faith in the Lord. So where there is true love, there is obedience. Many of us today don't feel like obeying our parents, our spouse, our authorities, our elders, because we really don't love them anymore. We try to find fault. You know, we see their limitations and their weaknesses and their vulnerabilities or their failures, which keeps us away from loving them. And ultimately, you feel more satisfied when you are in right relationship with God, which can only come through obedience. Often God's greatest blessings come as a result of your willingness to do something that appears so very insignificant. You know, that's why we read in 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 22, obedience is better than sacrifice. We might have heard about this so many times. You know, if the children don't listen to the parents, parents quote the scripture saying, obedience is better than sacrifice. Sometimes Roger also tells me, obedience is better than sacrifice. You know, because it is so difficult to obey, you know. So obedience is rightly placed before all other sacrifices. Obedience is more meritorious than any other penance that we do in our life. Obedience is very important for God because it implies a right relationship with Him as our loving Father. The Catechism of the Catholic Church in paragraph number 397 says, man tempted by the devil, let his trust in his creator die in his heart. And abusing his freedom, disobeyed God's command. This is what man's first sin consisted of. All subsequent sin would be disobedience towards God and the lack of trust in his goodness. And that's why Jesus, through his perfect obedience and sacrificial death, has once for all made atonement for our sins. And he empowered us with the Holy Spirit so that through the help of the Holy Spirit, we will be able to obey God. Else it is the most difficult task for us to obey God. Christian obedience is an act of love. It's a free gift of the self. Obedience stems out of love. That's why Saint Ignatius said, it is not hard to obey when we love the one whom we obey. You know, we see in the life of Saint Elizabeth, she obeyed God even when they had to name her son, then everyone else in the relatives and friends wanted to name him after his father, Zechariah. Elizabeth named him John, as per what the angel of the Lord told them to do. Being obedient to God, even if you have to face persecutions and hate from others, will always bring blessings at the end. We see innumerable examples in the Bible and the life of the Catholic Church. All who reap the fruit of obedience, everybody points out to one virtue, and that is obedience. You know, Saint Faustina in her diary wrote about the Lord telling her, my daughter, know that you give me greater glory by a single act of obedience than by long prayers and mortifications. The life of Elizabeth teaches us how important it is for us to be obedient to God. You know, the second aspect of her life was that she was committed to her calling as a mother. Even though she conceived in her old age, she proved to be a very good mother to her son, John the Baptist. You know, God chose a woman of faith and obedience to raise and teach an important prophet, John the Baptist. It is by the Holy Spirit and by the Word of God that one is to teach and to inspire the children. As parents, all of you should have that same desire to teach and inspire your children in the ways of the Lord. It is true that John the Baptist was special, and there was none like him, the greatest of all the prophets. But there is a lesson here that all of us have to learn. Both Elizabeth and Zechariah taught their son about God and the role and mission God wanted him to fulfill in his life. We need to ask ourselves as mothers, are you doing that with your children? Do your children know the ways of the Lord? And do they really know why they are born on this earth? The world is changing so rapidly, but the basic needs and the necessity of children from infancy to young adulthood remains the same. meeting their physical or mental, social, emotional, and spiritual needs are all important today than the earlier years, I would say. Now, most mothers are busy only fulfilling a child's material and physical needs, maybe. But what about their emotional and spiritual needs? I understand that no family is perfect. In every family, there are moments of happiness and sadness. There are issues to be addressed, forgiveness to be granted, and the work of healing to be done. It is very difficult to forget about the past hurtful experiences and truly see your family members the way Jesus sees them. Many times we only see the fault, the failures, and the limitations of our close people, especially our family members. But if we really want to be like Jesus, it is an act of love that involves selflessness, forgiveness, and sacrifice like Jesus, so that we treat our family members just like the way Jesus would treat us. It is better for me to ask myself, what can I do to change myself? How can I be a good mother? We are reminded of this beautiful spirit of wisdom of John's mother in the words of John the Baptist himself when he spoke to Jesus. He said, he must increase and I must decrease. That we read in John chapter 3, verse 30. It's a very famous saying of John the Baptist. He says, he must increase and I must decrease. We are reminded of this beautiful spirit of his godly nature, which came from his mother who taught him to be more godly and humble. The most lasting memorial to Elizabeth and the great mother of John the Baptist is to be found in the words of Jesus himself. We read that in Matthew chapter 11, verse 11. Truly I tell you, among those born of women, no one has arisen greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. If you are a single mother, or a mother whose spouse has given up on you, or a mother who is struggling with family issues, or a mother who is burdened in life, I want to encourage you today with the example of Saint Monica, the mother of Saint Augustine, the doctor of the church. Years of patient love and powerful prayers paid off at the end of her life. Faith in her Lord Jesus Christ and the knowledge that prayer is the first and best tool at any mother's disposal. The child of those tears shall never perish, said Saint Ambrose. So when you constantly pray for your children, and when you know that prayer is the best weapon which can defeat every work of the enemy to bring back your child in the way of the Lord, like St. Ambrose beautifully said, a child of tears will never perish.
I actually never knew that there was things that we could talk about Elizabeth and like beyond the things that we know from the Bible, but you really put it well about these virtues that you right now explained to us. It was really quite insightful about how we can take away so much from Elizabeth's obedience, obviously being super important, and also about how mothers raise their children right and they become amazing sons and daughters, you know, to the world because of that hard work put into the moms. So definitely Elizabeth taught us some good stuff, quite different from our other episodes as well. So that's really helpful. So thank you for sharing that. I'd like to ask you, what, when it comes to these virtues that you just explained, what does our church teach us about that?
You rightly said, Calvin, because when I thought about this character of Saint Elizabeth, I also was wondering, except for the first chapter of Luke, we really don't hear anything else, and there is nothing much to learn. But it was during the time of prayer and the time of study that I realized that God helped me to find out some unique characters, which is very insightful and very helpful for us any part of our lives, and very difficult. But then also got to know how we can really work it out in our lives. You know? What actually the church talks about obedience, the Catechism of the Catholic Church, paragraph 144, to obey in faith is to submit freely to the word that has been heard, because its truth is guaranteed by God, who is truth itself. Abraham is the model of such obedience offered us by sacred scriptures. The Virgin Mary is its most perfect embodiment. So that was from the CCC. Apart from that, even till today, we remember what Elizabeth first proclaimed. You know, after the angel's greeting to our Blessed Mother, we make Elizabeth's greeting our own. Filled with the Holy Spirit, Elizabeth is the first person who called Mary to be blessed. You know, Elizabeth's greeting, as you mentioned at the beginning, said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb," has formed the second part of the Hail Mary prayer. And even till today, we pray the rosary and we repeat her prayer and her exclamation that she proclaimed is still used in the Catholic Church. You know, I feel this is what the Church has taught us.
That's really nice what the Church has to teach us. It connects really well with Elizabeth, and also nice to know that our prayer, our daily prayer, I would say, is something that comes from a wonderful greeting from Elizabeth, who we are talking about today. Do you have anything from your life that you'd like to add and share with us today?
Yes, I would like to share a personal experience of my life. When I was doing my MBA, I was also working. You know, I was then involved in the ministry work through a retreat center here in Hyderabad. Then I was a youth leader then. So that was too much of responsibilities. Okay, I had to write my final exams and I hardly had time to prepare because I had my job. I had the ministry work. Especially, it was a very hectic time because we had exactly at that time our youth retreat coming up. And we had almost 500 to 600 young people coming for the retreat. Okay, so I had to prepare the schedules. I had to organize the whole program. And I have to preach. There was quite a lot of work even before the retreat. From the time of making posters and ensuring it is delivered to the parishes. And announcements are made. Banners are delivered. And registrations are taken care. The menu is discussed. And the whole program is organized. Bring in the resource people. So there was a lot of things to be organized. Yes. So I tried finishing all my work of organizing that. And then I went back home from the retreat center so that I can prepare for my exams. Okay, so I didn't really have much time to prepare for my exams then. So on the day of the exam, especially on the day of, I remember this one paper very clearly of financial management. Okay, I wasn't prepared really well for that. And the paper itself was very tough. So you can't blame me for that. In the examination hall, I prayed to the Holy Spirit to help me to remember everything that I studied. Okay. And especially most of the students who were writing their exams in the class, were finding it very difficult even to start the paper because it was difficult. So there was this good teacher who knew that everybody was struggling to even start one line and it was very difficult. Out of his generosity, out of his kindness, he told, okay, I understand that this paper has come very tough. So I allow you to copy in the class. What would you do, Calvin? No, and the teacher, out of obedience.
Of course, you have to listen to the teacher, right?
So the moment he told that you can copy, almost the whole class was copying. And quickly some of them ran outside to take books, textbooks, and open the textbooks, and they were all writing. Trust me, it was such a kind of temptation in my life as a student. I was sweating. And this temptation to copy was so strong within me, shouting aloud, "It's okay, you can copy now and go for confession and confess your sin. God will anyways forgive you." Okay, this temptation was so strong to copy in the class. Okay, but there was the still voice of the Holy Spirit within me saying, "No, don't copy, but be truthful." So I had to make a choice. And I'm telling you, it wasn't easy at all because everybody was copying. And it was a real struggle for me. And added to that, the invigilator, he came to me and he said, "Do you need some help?" So I told him, "No, I don't want to copy." Okay, so finally, with a lot of struggle, I had to say to myself, I will not copy. Even if it means that I fail my MBA, I will still be truthful and be obedient to God's voice. I finished my paper. At the end, I prayed over my paper because this is a habit that I have to pray over everything. Even if it means the smallest thing. Even now I do that, okay? Even if I'm cooking or I'm baking, I put a sign of the cross on that and invoke the presence of Jesus. So whatever I do comes out well. Okay, so I did that. After I finished my paper, I told the Lord and made a small prayer in my heart. And I said, Jesus, anoint this paper with your precious blood. Cover this paper with your precious blood so that I find, as I find favor in your eyes, I find favor in the eyes of the examiner who corrects my paper. Okay, so there's nothing wrong in praying anything to God. So I believe that. So after I prayed, I submitted the paper and I came back. And then after a few months later, the results have come. My dad was 100% sure that I will fail because he knew that I did not prepare. And I was so engrossed in the ministry work and my job. I didn't really prepare well. And to everyone's surprise, when I saw my results in financial management, I had got the highest marks of 77.
Amazing.
Thank Jesus.
Yeah. Holy Spirit always comes to
rescue you.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's a testimony that I will always cherish because I know when you are faithful, when you're truthful and obedient to God, the outcome, the result is great, always a miracle. I'm going to conclude my testimony with the quote of Saint Mary Magdalene. She said, a single instant passed under simple obedience is immeasurably more valuable in the sight of God than an entire day spent in the most sublime contemplation, which means even if you spend one whole day in silence and contemplating and reflecting the life of God, or you know, doing so many mortifications and things like that, is nothing compared to that small thing that you do in obedience for God.
That's actually so powerful. Yeah, thank you. I really loved your testimony. It obviously connects a lot to a lot of youth, I would say, because a lot of us go through these difficult moments in our exams. And, you know, I mean, it's been a really long time since I did mine, but like, I'm just saying, it just brings back those memories when we had those, we were stuck in those moments. And the way you approached it is something that really, like, I would say it shocked me, because obviously that time I wasn't with God, so I never really even would think of that. But now that you said it, like in a way that it's like you relied on God more than relying on something that this world has to offer. You relied on something divine, because you yourself said that you hadn't studied very well, and your the fact that you yourself were unsure was that you put your full trust in God and you stayed obedient to His commandments, basically, that where we shouldn't cheat, or we shouldn't, like, you know, do the things that is wrong, and that's wrong in God's eyes, and you stuck by that. And again, the Holy Spirit, as awesome as He always is, He helped you through because of your obedience, again, them all being God. So that really takes a big part of our heart where it says we need to be obedient no matter what, whether it's small or big, or even at moments where you feel stuck, like you were, you still decided to rely on God, which is beautiful. I really love that part. Also, Elizabeth thought, like I said before, I didn't know that there was so much that we could learn from her. And now these virtues, they're so impactful, especially obedience. I mean, obedience, we see Abraham. He started off pretty strong, and but then everyone else follows suit. Also Moses, and then Jesus, most of all. I mean, like, that obedience is like on another whole level that no one can keep up with. But definitely it is so strong that at that time, even though he was he had a really hard time being obedient. He still was, and that led to the salvation of the world. And even Mama Mary, like, you know, it was her obedience and to the Father's will, and, like, you know, to, even though she wasn't ready, she trusted in him, and that was amazing. So now today we saw someone who we don't even look at as, you know, very important from the Bible, who was taught as this very important virtue. And I really think that a lot of us have much to take away from this. So thank you so much for sharing these things. It really is very impactful, and God bless you for all the hard work you put into it. Something take away from all that we learned today?
I would only say one thing. The power of obedience. At the lake of Gennesaret, had denied its fishes to Peter's nets. A whole night in vain, but obedient to Jesus, he lowered his net again to the waters, and they caught huge number of fish. Believe me, the miracle is repeated every single day if we do it out of obedience.
Amen. Amen. Absolutely. Absolutely. That's wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you, Calvin, for being so encouraging and listening. And also thank you to all our viewers. For week after week, you come and help us and enrich us by your faith and by your sharing of these videos, and above all, praying for us. So I pray in turn for you and your family, that you truly have the grace of being obedient through the Holy Spirit, and the grace as mothers to bring up a great generation into this world, so that we as Catholics will be known by our love, and through your upbringing, the next generation will be blessed. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's wonderful. Thank you, Sister Jessie. And thank you all for being here. As you just heard, a lot of grace coming your way. Accepted. Let God empower you to be obedient, and also to receive all the wonderful blessings he has for you because of it. Have a wonderful week ahead, and we'll see you soon. God bless. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.